Let's bring in Greg Henderson, editor of Beef Today. He's been in school this week. He's been to Cowboy College. Are you smarter now, Greg?
Just a little bit, Mike. this is a great segue from the free-range chickens into, as you know, we've talked many times about how important animal health, animal welfare are, and how our industry is taking steps to try and improve that. We held our first Cowboy College in Omaha, and we had 135 producers there. These are people who are feedlot cowboys, pen riders, animal health crews. They all came to listen to the three veterinarians that we had on board. Dan Thompson, who is the director of the Beef Cattle Institute at Kansas State, Mike Apley, veterinarian, is also at Kansas State, and Tom Knopfinger, who is a consulting feedlot veterinarian from Bakel, Nebraska. The issues that they talked about were management of newly received cattle, low-stress cattle handling, and managing high-risk calves the first 45 days on feed. Also, they talked about antibiotic therapy for getting cattle well. And all in all, it was just a very engaged audience. As you know, this is the time of year when we see a lot of calves coming into feed yards, so it was very, very timely. In addition to that, I want to point out that all of the people who attended our conference became BQA certified. That's Beef Quality Assurance certified. And that's a very important program. And in fact, Boehringer Ingelheim Vet Medica is sponsoring Beef Quality Assurance training for anyone who wants to go online and take those courses. It's free of charge now through October 31. You can go to the Beef Cattle Institute website, and that's beefcattleinstitute.org. Take the BQA training, see what the latest techniques and how to handle your cattle even better. It's important as we sign up as many people in our industry as we can for BQA training.
Yeah, those are good programs. We encourage producers to do so. All right, Greg, thanks a lot.
Thank you, Mike.
Let's bring in Greg Henderson, editor of Beef Today. He's been in school this week. He's been to Cowboy College. Are you smarter now, Greg?
Just a little bit, Mike. this is a great segue from the free-range chickens into, as you know, we've talked many times about how important animal health, animal welfare are, and how our industry is taking steps to try and improve that. We held our first Cowboy College in Omaha, and we had 135 producers there. These are people who are feedlot cowboys, pen riders, animal health crews. They all came to listen to the three veterinarians that we had on board. Dan Thompson, who is the director of the Beef Cattle Institute at Kansas State, Mike Apley, veterinarian, is also at Kansas State, and Tom Knopfinger, who is a consulting feedlot veterinarian from Bakel, Nebraska. The issues that they talked about were management of newly received cattle, low-stress cattle handling, and managing high-risk calves the first 45 days on feed. Also, they talked about antibiotic therapy for getting cattle well. And all in all, it was just a very engaged audience. As you know, this is the time of year when we see a lot of calves coming into feed yards, so it was very, very timely. In addition to that, I want to point out that all of the people who attended our conference became BQA certified. That's Beef Quality Assurance certified. And that's a very important program. And in fact, Boehringer Ingelheim Vet Medica is sponsoring Beef Quality Assurance training for anyone who wants to go online and take those courses. It's free of charge now through October 31. You can go to the Beef Cattle Institute website, and that's beefcattleinstitute.org. Take the BQA training, see what the latest techniques and how to handle your cattle even better. It's important as we sign up as many people in our industry as we can for BQA training.
Yeah, those are good programs. We encourage producers to do so. All right, Greg, thanks a lot.
Thank you, Mike.